Okay, we're here at Lehigh Judo, finishing up a seminar with Rigan Machado. And Rigan, there's a lot of guys out there that want to get into grappling and Brazilian Jiu Jitsu, and we want to know what you think would help them the most to have success in grappling and Brazilian Jiu Jitsu.
The key for me is to first structure a base. The base for me is the key for a good game in the sport. Because a lot of people is learning a lot of information, but the information get confused. The key is a good chess game. For me, the most important is create a good structure. Get somebody who know what they're talking about to go with the ABC techniques. Because when you have that structure, it's going to be very easy to build your game.
So when you say base, you mean more... I guess you say...
I can explain to you in a better way. Imagine like a pizza. We have many different parts of the pie. Okay? Jiu-jitsu is called the complete circle. What you mean? You put your back on the ground, you're on the top, you're on the bottom. You know what I mean? You try to attack the arm, the neck, the legs. It basically, like for you get good in this game, it's very important you learn all different pieces of the pie to create that rotation, to learn how to fight on the top, how to go to the bottom, from the bottom go to the top. In this motion, what's going to help to create your own game. That's why it's very important to learn these pieces of the pie.
What would you recommend to somebody that's crossing over from another sport like judo or wrestling?
When you come from a different type of grappling, in my mind, I don't think names, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, judo, sambo. I think I'm a grappler. Whatever I can do to make my grappling better, I want to take advantage.
That's great. That's a big part of what I've tried to talk to guys about too. How did you do that when you were competing in sambo and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and all the different styles?
My experience like competing, which I think I love the competition. I think competition is a good motivation for you put more time on the mat. I try adapt. Like I give you an example. When I fought judo, I try play the game in judo by the rules to bring the guy for the ground, which is my best area. The same in sambo. When I fought sambo, I bring the fight to the ground. Even in wrestling, when I start competing freestyle wrestling, I try to keep on the ground, I try to roll the guy, I focus on the ground because that's the place I do my game best. That's my best experience. The same in case the MMA fights I did, I do the same. I don't want to fight in an area who is not my 100% ability. I want to be sure I learn enough to use the ground to take the fight, to take the control on the ground and have a chance to do the submissions.
So really focusing on building your base and developing your best skills and making them work.
It's a chess game. I'm sorry about my phone.
No problem.
It's my phone. It's going to stop in 2 seconds. I'm sorry about that.
That's okay.
What's the question?
So just to kind of wrap up here, who were your biggest, I guess, heroes in jiu-jitsu or grappling when you were growing up and why?
I think the reason, my favorite, my mentor, was one of my coach named Ruiz Gracie. The reason I like Ruiz Gracie, because Ruiz Gracie, he was the first Brazilian jiu-jitsu guys to do freestyle wrestling, to do judo, to do sambo, to open the mind for try use all the styles to make your style more well complete. I follow Holly's mentality. I try whatever I can do to learn in different styles or different rep for my style to be better, we'll try.
That's great. Thanks so much. We loved having you out here and hope we can get to see you again soon.
It's my honor to be here, sir.
Thanks a lot, Rigan.
Thank you.